Before we jump into today's video, be sure to look at this photograph. Hit that subscribe button if you're new. And if y'all would like us to do another one of these videos at 1400 days logged in, be sure to
let me smash
that like button. But yeah, first we're going to start off with the resources. And like always, I will leave a link to the timestamps in the description if you want to jump to a specific part. Next up, we're going to take a look at all of my schematics. As right now, I only have 4 maxed out to power level 144. I do plan on finishing maxing out the Xenon Bow, and I also want to max out the Mythic Storm King's Wrath, but I'm going to need some more weapon superchargers before I can do that. But yeah, if you got some weapon superchargers, I would recommend using them on either the Deatomizer, the Pod Shot, Xenon Bow, Mythic Storm King's Wrath, mainly because those are some of the best weapons in Save the World, and they're really useful in just about every situation. There are still quite a few schematics that I need to max the perks out on. I've only leveled up a couple more since the previous video, the one we did at 1200 days. Usually I like to max out as many weapons as I can before I do these videos, but I didn't bother doing it this time because I noticed that the only weapons we don't have evolved to power level 130 are base game weapons. So we have all the event weapons to power level 130. But we don't have all of the regular base game weapons to 130. And like I said, I could have maxed some of them out, but I didn't bother doing it because I don't really plan on using them. And plus I need like a lot more legendary perk up before I can max out all of their perks. So I didn't bother maxing them out this time, but if we get enough legendary perk up and enough pure drops of rain, then we'll try maxing out all of the base game weapons as well. And that reminds me, if you take a look at the weekly shop, there is a lot of legendary perk up available this week, and there's also a Guardian's Will available, which is this sword right here. And the reason I would recommend getting it is because you can put movement speed perks on it, and it also has a really useful heavy attack that helps you get around the map a lot easier. So make sure you get that legendary perk up and Guardian's Will if you haven't already. But yeah, every time we do these videos, somebody always asks me, how am I still playing Save the World? For those who don't know, we do stream other games on Twitch. I just haven't bothered uploading them yet because I want to make sure that when we start uploading other games, it's going to be something that everybody can enjoy. Even if you don't particularly play that game, I want to make sure you can still enjoy the video. So we will start uploading some more games soon. But yeah, we have been playing other games on Twitch. And for those who didn't see the previous video, they're going to be adding some new content to Save the World. So I'm going to stick around and make sure we check that out. For those who are wondering, supposedly they're going to add like a new dungeon to dungeons. I'm not sure when that's going to be, but we are going to go ahead and stick around and check that out. But yeah, 1300 days, that's the longest I've stuck with any game since I started YouTube. I think the longest I stuck around for any game before this was GTA 5, and I only played that for like a year. So this is definitely the longest I've ever stuck around for one game. And yes, it would be easier if they added new content. But yeah, whenever I get bored or tired or Save the World, I'll just take a break or play a different game. And that sort of helped me stick around for this long. But yeah, it hasn't been easy staying this long, especially over the past year or two, because we haven't really gotten anything new. So it's one of the main reasons I haven't been uploading that much, is because we don't really have any new content, and I don't want to redo the same weapons and heroes over and over again. But I am currently looking for some other games to play and upload. As a matter of fact, let me know if there's any games that you all would like us to try out, or if you all would like us to try some more VR or creative mode or whatever. Just let us know in the comments what you all would like to see, and we'll try it out. But yeah, those are all of my 130 weapons. As you can see, we have a bunch of base game weapons that I haven't maxed out yet. We could have maxed out a few of them, but I didn't bother doing it this time. But yeah, those are pretty much all of my schematics. Next up, we'll go ahead and take a look at all of my heroes that we have at 130. And I'm going to go ahead and scroll over each of them so you all can see the perks for those who don't know their perks. As you can tell, we do have all of the mythic heroes leveled up to 130, but I don't have any heroes maxed out to 144 yet. I do have a bunch of hero superchargers, but I just haven't bothered using them because we don't really need them at this point. I think the first hero I'm gonna max out though is Power Base Penny, mainly because she's useful in almost every situation. And I think the one I'm going to max out after her is Stoneheart Pharah, because she's really good with the Xenon bow. But yeah, I haven't actually even considered using my hero superchargers. For those of you who have used yours, let me know which heroes you use them on. I'm not sure how many I have at the moment. Matter of fact, let's go ahead and double check. Okay, I got 21 hero superchargers. So I could max out a couple of them if I wanted to. Like I said, the only reason I haven't used them yet is because you don't really need them. But yeah, when it comes to heroes, we got all of the event heroes maxed out, or leveled up to 130, I should say. And we also have quite a few of the base game heroes leveled up to 130 as well. I don't think we have every base game hero though, because a lot of them have the same perks as some of the event heroes. So I didn't bother maxing them out since they have the same perks and it would sort of be a waste. Plus I'm kind of low when it comes to training manuals. I could get a bunch from my extra defenders and extra survivors that I have laying around. So that's not really an issue. But for now, we're just going to stay with 130. We have reviewed most of these heroes. I will leave a link to a playlist that includes all of our weapon and hero reviews if you'd like to check any of them out. Also, as of right now, we're only power level 134. I believe the highest you can get is power level 135. And we do have some survivor superchargers. So once we take a look at our survivor squads, I may use some of those superchargers and see what our real power level is. I'm not sure if we'll have enough to get the 135, but we'll see once we check out the survivors. And we're also going to check out everything in our locker as well. So we're going to take a look at our pickaxes, our skins, and some of our emotes. But yeah, I think we'll stream on Twitch as soon as I upload this video. As of right now, I'm only level 41 in Ventures, and I would like to get the 50 before the Venture season ends. So I think we'll stream some Ventures on Twitch later today. I'll leave a link to my Twitch in the description if you haven't followed already. But yeah, I think we're coming up to the end of all of my power level 130 heroes. And as you see, we have a couple of base game heroes I haven't maxed out yet. But yeah, those are all of my heroes. I haven't made any changes when it comes to defenders. I'm still looking for some defenders that have like the perfect perks on them. So until I find them, I'm just gonna stick with the ones that I have for now. And none of these other ones are maxed out. But yeah, those are all my defenders. Next up, we'll go ahead and take a look at my survivor squads. All right, so before we take a look at our squads, I am gonna go ahead and use all of my survivor superchargers. We should be able to get there. Boom, we just reached 135, people. And here's what my squads currently look like. So we do still have a little bit of room for improvement when it comes to our bonuses. I could switch a couple of these around and make it a little bit more efficient. But as of right now, this is what my squads currently look like. Next up, we're gonna take a look at everything in my backpack. And I don't want to waste too much time on these. I do have quite a bit of 144s that people have gifted me. I also got some 130s that people gifted me. But I don't even use these that often, because usually when I play Save the World, I'm in Venture Zone. So I don't even get a chance to use these. But yeah, those are all of the weapons that I currently have. And here are all the traps that I currently have in my inventory. Again, a lot of these traps, or at least the ones that are 144, are ones that people gifted to me, but the rest of these are ones that I crafted. And here's everything I have when it comes to ingredients. So that's everything that's currently in my backpack, and here's everything that's in my storage. I'm only going to scroll over the weapons because a lot of them have some unique perks, and these are like the rarest guns that I have. A fire snowball launcher, double element typewriter, a water vacuum tube launcher. So yeah, this is where I keep all of my rare weapons. This one that has a bunch of perks on it. But yeah, I'm only gonna show the weapons. I'm not gonna bother showing all of this other stuff. But yeah, this is everything that I currently have in my storage. And I guess we'll go ahead and take a look at the collection book. I'm not gonna scroll over each one. I'm just gonna pop them open so you can see which ones we have completed. If they have a check mark next to it, that means we have everything for that. Let's see what else we got. Oh, yep, we got some check marks down here as well. Here's all the events. We're missing quite a few of those. as well as expansion people and expansion schematics. Whereas right now we got level 288 in the collection book. And the last thing we're going to take a look at is everything that's in my locker. So first we're going to start off with the skins. Then we'll check out the pickaxes and the emotes, the loading screens, and the background music. But first we're going to start off with the skins. And big shout out to everybody who's been donating skins lately. We've had a lot of people gift me skins while I'm streaming or off stream. And we've also had a lot of people donate emotes as well. I usually try to tweet it out whenever somebody gifts me something. So, and speaking of Twitter, be sure to follow me on Twitter if y'all haven't already. I only tweet like maybe once every day or two, so I don't really tweet a whole lot. But whenever I find out something new, I usually tweet it out first. But yeah, usually, most of the time, when somebody gifts me something, I try to tweet it out and thank them that way. Also, big shout out to everybody who's using the Support a Creator code. If you do use the Support a Creator code, be sure to tweet it at me and I'll retweet it for you. But yeah, for those who haven't noticed, YouTube hasn't really been doing that well lately. So believe it or not, using that creator code really helps me out. It keeps the party going. Probably wouldn't have been able to stick around this long if it wasn't for you all using the creator code and people who donate during streams. So yeah, just wanted to say thank you. I appreciate you. I see you. And your support really helps out. And since we're talking about skins, let me know in the comments, which skin is your favorite or which one have you used the most up to this point? When it comes to Save the World, I think the one that I've used the most is Power Base Penny. But when it comes to BR and Creative, the one that I use the most is Tropical Punch Zoe, which we'll show here shortly. But yeah, the reason I like those two skins is because, I don't know, it reminds me of candy. You know what I mean? And I got a sweet tooth, you know? So those are probably my most used skins up to this point. I haven't been in contact with Fortnite or anything. Like, I don't have any special privileges, but it would be really awesome if we could get an A1 Get This Money bundle. I don't know if Epic's watching, but there's like a handful of people out here who want the A1 Get This Money bundle. Make it happen, Epic. I know we probably don't get enough viewers for them to actually consider us. Starfish is another skin that I really like. But yeah, I know we probably don't get enough views to get our own bundle, but yeah, just wanted to put that out there just in case anybody's listening. I also like the Takara skin, and shout out to Mateo Mango for gifting this one to us. But yeah, I think that would be really cool. Oh, and here's the Tropical Punch Zoe skin I was talking about. I think I use this the most when we play creative in VR. Like I said, it reminds me of candy, and I got a sweet tooth. But yeah, Fortnite or Epic, they've only interacted with me once, and that was when they tweeted out one of my videos back in 2017. I think it was like a winter event tips video or something like that, and they tweeted out that video, and that was the only time they actually like interacted with me. I think I've had a couple of their community managers stop by a stream maybe once or twice, but for whatever reason, they haven't really paid much attention to the channel since then. I don't know. I'm not saying I deserve my own bundle. I'm just saying I've been here since day one. I know we got 1300 days logged in, but technically I've been playing for almost 4 years because I missed a lot of logins. But yeah, not saying I deserve it, but it would be nice if we had our own bundle. I know at least like 2 or 3 people who would pay money for it. Not trying to brag or anything, but yeah, there's demand, Epic. But yeah, those are all of my skins. We'll go ahead and take a look at the back blings. And I know this video is going on long, so I'm not going to scroll over each one. I'm just going to scroll down. Hopefully y'all can see them good enough. Let me know if this is okay, just scrolling down like this. Because, well, like this one, you can't really see it. This one's kind of hard to see as well. But yeah, I don't want to scroll over each one because it would make this video a little bit too long. I think I'm gonna do the same thing with the emotes. But if you all want us to scroll over each one in the next video, then let me know in the comments. But for now, this is probably one of my most used back blings. I use this one with Tropical Punch Zoe. But yeah, I'm just gonna scroll down because I don't want this video to go on forever, people. So yeah, those are all of my back blings that I have at the moment. Same thing with pickaxes. I'm not going to scroll over them unless they're like grayed out or something. I don't really have that many pickaxes anyways. But yeah, we're just gonna scroll down, check these out, see which ones I got. Let me know in the comments what your favorite pickaxe is. I think the one that I use the most is this one right here, the Storm King Fist. I was able to get that one from the BR item shop when Horde Bash limited time mode was available. But yeah, those are all of my pickaxes. Same thing with wraps. I'm not going to scroll over each of these. I think the one that I use the most is the Enigma, because I use that with Tropical Punch Zoe and Power Base Penny. Also use Rainbow Rodeo a lot. Let me know which wraps you all use the most up to this point. But yeah, hopefully you all can see most of those. Again, if y'all want me to scroll over each one in the next video, just let me know in the comments below. I didn't want the video to go on too long. But yeah, those are all of the wraps that I currently have. So I am gonna go ahead and scroll over each of our music packs, because you can't really tell what the music pack is until you see the name of it. We're not gonna listen to them though. But I think the ones that I like the most are, well, I like this drop in because it's like a real song, but you don't get in trouble for it. Like, you won't get a DMCA strike for it. So I do like that one. Hopefully they'll add some more music packs like that in the future. But I think the one that I use the most is this one called Boss Battle. For those who haven't noticed, I also use that as background music in my videos. But yeah, let me know which music pack is your favorite. And last up, we're gonna go through all of our emotes. And these are also kind of hard to see by just looking at the icon. So I'm gonna go ahead and scroll over all of these as well. And this may take a while, people. We pretty much covered everything else. Like I said, I do plan on streaming later on today, so be sure to follow us on Twitch if you'd like to hang out with us. Also, be sure to join our Discord if you haven't already. Play Save the World. You can find a lot of people on there to help you out or to hang out and play with. Or even if you don't play Save the World or Fortnite, you just come hang out with us on Discord. We got a lot of people that play other games as well, and we don't just talk about games. We also talk about other stuff. We also do giveaways on Discord, so be sure to join if you haven't already. And for those who don't have Discord, we also have a Facebook group. I'll leave a link to that in the description as well. Believe it or not, I am really looking forward to season 7, mainly because it involves aliens and spaceships and UFOs and getting abducted. And it kind of reminds me of what I expected to see in Save the World. Like, I thought eventually we were going to go out into space, maybe on the moon or something. But we never got that content. And now that I see that content coming to VR, I kind of want to try it out just to see what it's like. Also, apparently there's a lot of Save the World characters that's going to be included in Season 7 VR. I believe Dennis is going to play a role, as well as Mari, according to some leaks that I found on Twitter. So we will be playing some Season 7 in VR for those two reasons. And another thing I wanted to mention before I go is that you can now gift bundles to people, and they don't have to be in your friends list. It came with last week's update, but I forgot to mention it. So it should be like a lot easier to do giveaways now, like on Twitch or when we're streaming. And like, even if somebody owns a couple items of that bundle, it'll get excluded, so you don't have to give them duplicate items. And yeah, that was another thing I wanted to mention. When it comes to emotes, I'm trying to think which one is my favorite. I really like the buckle up emote, the strut emote. I've been using the dribbling emote a lot lately. Wait, why does he look so tiny? Let me know in the comments which emote is your favorite. I can't even think of one that I would consider my favorite. I don't use one like all the time, so I'm not sure which one is my favorite, but if you have a favorite one, let me know in the comments below. But yeah, I think we're coming up on the end of all of my emotes. Let me know what you all think about my inventory after 1300 days logged in. Let me know if y'all would like us to continue doing this more in the future once we reach 1400 days logged in. And if there's any other games out there that you all would like us to play or upload or stream on Twitch, then let me know about those in the comments as well. But yeah, that sums up everything we're going to go over for this one. I hope y'all enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.